Romans chapter 1. This is written to believers, to Christians that were meeting at a place called Colossae. And chapter 1, Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God, and Timotheus, our brother, to the saints and faithful brethren in Christ which are at Colossae. Grace be unto you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. We give thanks to God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, praying always for you. Since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and of the love which ye have to all the saints, in other words, to all the believers, for the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, whereof he heard before in the word of the truth of the gospel. Now you say, what is the gospel? The gospel is how that Christ died for our sins according to scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. Why? So that you and I could be saved. You and I have a soul that needs to be saved, my friend. And our soul leaves our body at the moment of death. Where will you be 5 seconds after you die? This is the all-important question. And what you do with Jesus Christ will determine where you'll be throughout all of eternity. And as I often say, eternity is a long time to be wrong. If you die in your sins, and if you believe not that I am he, the Lord Jesus said, ye shall die in your sins. And where I go, ye cannot come. So we've got to understand the only way to heaven is through the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God who died on the cross for you and for me. Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and he was buried, and he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. Is your soul saved? Are you on your way to heaven? Or are you still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? There's no need for that, my friend. God wants you to be in heaven. But the only way you can be in heaven is through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God who came down from heaven to die upon the cross. Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and he was buried. But praise God, the third day he rose again according to the scriptures. I wonder, is your soul saved? Are you on your way to heaven, or are you still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? There's no need for that. God wants you to be in heaven, my friend. And the only way you can be there is through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. Yes, since we heard of your faith in Christ Jesus and the love which he have to all the saints, for the hope which is laid up for you in heaven, whereof ye heard before in the word of the truth of the gospel, which is come unto you as it is in all the world, and bringeth forth fruit as it doth also in you, since the day ye heard of it and knew the grace of God in truth. As ye also learned of Epaphras, our dear fellow servant, who is for you a faithful minister of Christ, who also declared unto us your love in the Spirit. For this cause we also, since the day we heard it, do not cease to pray for you and to desire that ye might be filled with the knowledge of his will, in all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that ye might walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God, strengthened with all might according to his glorious power, unto all patience and long-suffering with joyfulness, giving thanks unto the Father which hath made us meet or fit to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in light, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. Have you been delivered from the power of darkness, that is, from the power of the devil? You see, if you're not saved, my friend, the devil has you right where he wants you. You and I have to realize that we've been deceived by the devil. The devil has blinded the minds of them that believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, which is the power of God and salvation to everyone that believeth, should shine in unto them. And the devil wants you to go down to hell. He wants you to go down to the lake of fire and brimstone with himself. He knows he's going there, and he wants to take as many people with him as he can. We read that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Are you perishing, my friend? Are you on your way down to hell? And God does not want this for you. He doesn't want to have to judge you, but he will if you die without Christ as your Saviour. We need to understand the Lord Jesus Christ will either be our Saviour or he'll have to be our judge. What will it be for you? Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. That means he came to save you and he came to save me. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, being justified freely by his grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus. And so if you put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, my friend, your soul will be saved. That's exactly why I'm here today. I want you to know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. That you would come to know him. That you would believe upon him. That you would receive him as your Savior. Otherwise, he'll be your judge. It's up to you. What would you rather have, a Savior or a judge? Now, he's either going to be one of those things unto you. He's either going to be your Savior or he's going to be your judge. What will it be for you, my friend? God wants us to be with him for all eternity in heaven. He's done all he can to get us there, but we've got to put our faith in Jesus Christ. If we do not put our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, we'll be in hell at the moment of death, my friend. Why? Because our sins are taking us down there. You see, the problem is sin. It's only a little three-letter word, but it's so offensive to the God of heaven. God cannot have sin in his presence, my friend. And that's why you and I can never be in heaven in and of ourselves. That's why we need the Lord Jesus Christ as our Savior. But if he's not our Savior, he'll have to be our judge. What will it be for you? Salvation or damnation? Savior or judge? Heaven or hell? It's up to you. We determine our eternal destiny, my friend. And God wants us to be in heaven. Make no mistake about that. As I said before, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Have you believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God? To become a child of God, to be born again into God's family through faith in our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. You see, we are on our way down to hell, into the judgment of God because of our sins. And God does not want to have to judge us. But he will if we die without Jesus Christ as our Savior, because he will be our judge instead. Savior or judge, what would you rather have, my friend? And I know that I've received the Lord Jesus Christ as my Savior when I was 17 years old, and I'm 63 now, so it's a few years ago. But I've come to know him as my Savior. And I want you to come to know him as your Savior. Because without him, we are dead in our trespasses and in our sins, heading for the judgment of Almighty God, my friend. And that judgment will fall upon you without Christ as your Savior. You'll have to be judged for your sins, my friend, if you die without the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. It says here, who hath delivered us, it's written to Christians, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness, that is the devil, and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins. I wonder, have your sins been forgiven? Are you on your way to heaven? Or are you still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? There's thousands of millions of people upon that road, my friend. You need to change directions. You need to get right with God. You need to prepare, as this sign says, prepare to meet thy God. Why? Because it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God, and yet God will have all men to be saved and to come under the knowledge of the truth. The truth is found in the Word of God, the Bible. It's also found in a person, the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. He said in John 14, verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Have you come in repentance and faith? Repentance being a change of mind. Simply agree with God that you are a sinner, and then place your faith in our Lord and Savior,
Jesus Christ before it's forever and eternally too late. You see, we're running out of time, my friend. The Lord Jesus Christ will return soon.
He's coming back to take the Christians to be forever with himself. Then there's going to be 7 years of tribulation upon this earth. The last 3.5 years is called the Great Tribulation. No need to be left behind in any of that 7-year period. You're going to be caught up to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Praise the Lord for that. That is the Christian's hope. This is what we're waiting for now. But what about you? Will you be left behind to go through that terrible time of judgment upon the earth? Then not only that, but then at the end of the day, to stand before the one who could have been your Saviour, and you rejected him, or neglected him. It's the same outcome, my friend. It's hell in the lake of fire for all those who refuse to come in repentance toward God, as I've said. That is a change of mind. Simply agree with God that you are a sinner, and then place your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Are you prepared to call upon the name of the Lord this afternoon, my friend? If you're not, you're on your way to hell, my friend, and I'm telling you the truth here. If I wouldn't tell you the truth, it's not worth me being here preaching. I'm here to preach the good news of the gospel of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, how that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. But if you refuse to repent and trust Christ, repent is a change of mind. Simply agree with God that you are a sinner, and then believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Wonderful thing to know that your sins are forgiven, my friend, and that you're on your way to heaven. What about you? Are you on your way to heaven? Or are you still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? There's no need to stay on that broad road, my friend. You can get right with God, because it's a fearful thing to fall into the hands of the living God. Yet God will have all men to be saved. He wants to save your soul, my friend. This afternoon, if you come in repentance, acknowledging the fact that you are a sinner before the God of heaven, and then believing on the Lord Jesus Christ, you will obtain God's eternal salvation through faith in the finished work and the person of the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of God from heaven, one who left heaven's glory to come down to this sin-cursed earth to die upon the cross for you and for me. I wonder, how is it with your soul? If you were to die right now, my friend, where would you be? You need to think about eternal things. You need to think about the things that are lasting. The eternal thing, you see, the things that are seen are temporal. These bodies are only temporal, my friend. Even though we make so much fuss about our bodies, these things are only temporary. They're going to pass away. But we have a spirit and soul inside of our body. And those things leave our body at the moment of death. And it's either going to be in heaven through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, or it's going to be down in hell because we've rejected or neglected putting our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. In other words, we haven't received the Lord Jesus Christ as our Saviour. You see, he came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, that is Jesus Christ, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. Have you believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God, the Lord Jesus Christ, who died upon the cross so that you and I could be saved, so that you and I could be rescued from going down to that terrible place called hell and eventually be cast into the lake of fire and brimstone where there's weeping and gnashing of teeth? God does not want that for you, my friend. He wants you to be saved. Wonder, will you come to Jesus Christ this afternoon and be saved as a result of faith alone in him? I read in verse 15 of Colossians chapter 1, who is the image? This is about the Lord Jesus Christ. It's describing him. Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature? For by him were all things created, that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be
thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created by him and for him. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist, or all things hang together. You see, God created all things by Jesus Christ. We mustn't think the Lord Jesus Christ began to exist when he was born of Mary. That's wrong. He's the eternal, self-existent God, my friend. He said, before Abraham was, I am. Yes, he's the eternal one. And he's the one that wants to be your Saviour this afternoon. I wonder, will you cry out unto him this afternoon? For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. This can be yours this afternoon. By repentance toward God, acknowledging that you are a sinner before the God of heaven, and then believing on the Lord Jesus Christ, and as the Bible says, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things, or among all things, he might have the preeminence. In other words, he might have the first place. For it pleased the Father that in him, that is in Jesus Christ, should all fullness dwell. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven, and you that were sometime alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now hath he reconciled. You see, this is speaking unto the believers, the Christians, at a place called Colossae. And they were, in a past time, they were sometime alienated and enemies in our minds by wicked works. And if you're not saved, my friend, you are alienated, you are still alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works. You are the enemy of God. We're all the enemies of God by our wicked works and our sinful behavior, my friend, before we are saved. And this is why you need God's salvation urgently. Now is the day of salvation. Today, if you will hear his voice, that is the voice of God, harden not your heart. There's coming a time when it'll be too late to get saved, my friend. Too late to have peace with God. Too late to have a home in heaven. Through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. What will it be for you? Heaven or hell? The time is running out, my friend. Time is short. The time is running out. Our time on earth is running out. You and I will not live on earth forever. You know, sometimes the way people act and behave, you would think that they think they're going to live here forever. We're not. We are not eternal. Our bodies are not eternal. Our spirit and soul is eternal. Those things go off into eternity at the moment of death, my friend. They'll leave our body at the moment of death. But then where? Where will I be 5 seconds after I die? You need to think about eternal things for a change. And not just be so focused upon our bodies that are going to just vanish away and corrupt in the earth when they bury us. We have a spirit and soul that leaves our body at the moment of death, as I've said. We need to understand, we're going to be somewhere throughout all of eternity. How can we wrap our minds around eternity? It's impossible. We cannot wrap our minds around eternity. And eternity is forever. That's all we can really say, forever and ever. We cannot understand it. But you see, our spirit and soul will last forever, will exist forever. In one of two places. It's either going to be heaven through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, if I put my faith in him, or it's going to be down in the lake of fire and brimstone where there's weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth. No need to go there, my friend. God does not want you to go there. And that's why I'm preaching unto you this afternoon. So I have a love for your soul, my friend. Your soul needs to be saved. You need to get right with God. You need to come and have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. We see here, and having made peace through the blood of his cross, by him to reconcile all things unto himself, by him, I say, whether they be things in earth all things in heaven. And you that were sometime alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now hath he reconciled or made friends. Again, this is written unto Christians. In the body of his flesh, through death, to present you holy and unblameable and unreprovable in his sight. If ye continue in the faith, grounded and settled, and be not removed away from the hope of the gospel, which ye have heard, and which was preached to every creature which is under heaven, whereof I, Paul, am made a minister, who now rejoice in my sufferings for you, and fill up that which is behind of the afflictions of Christ in my flesh for his body's sake, which is the church, whereof I am made a minister according to the dispensation of God, which is given to me for you to fulfill the word of God, even the mystery which hath been hid from ages and from generations, but now is made manifest to his saints, to whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory, or Christ among you, the hope of glory, whom we preach. In other words, they're preaching Christ, and he's the one I'm interested in this afternoon. Preaching Christ and him crucified. He's the one that you've got to come to know, my friend, as your Saviour. Otherwise, he'll be your judge. And that's not a good thing. That's a terrifying thing, my friend, to face the Lord Jesus Christ as your judge. That would be absolutely horrifying to stand before him and know that there's no way of salvation and that you've left it too late, my friend. You need to act now. You need to get right with God now. Today is the day of salvation. In fact, today can be the day of your eternal salvation. And this is what God wants for each and every one of us, my friend, that we would be saved by his grace through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. In fact, there's no other way of salvation. Come to the one who said in John 14, verse 6, I am the way, not a way. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. When have you come in repentance and faith, acknowledging your sinful condition before the Lord? We have to do that. Do you really think you can pull the wool over God's eyes? He sees and knows everything, my friend. He's omniscient. That means he's all-knowing. He knows all things. He's omnipresent. That means he's everywhere, present everywhere at the same time. He knows those dodgy sites that you're clicking on, my friend. You know, that porn site or whatever it might be. God's all up with everything. There's nothing that takes him by surprise. He understands. He sees all these things. And we need to understand that we're in trouble. We're in big trouble because we're in trouble with the God of heaven. We're in trouble with Almighty God. We're not talking about the law of the land here. We're not talking about the police or the court or the magistrates, whatever it might be, or even the government. We're talking about Almighty God. We're in trouble. We're in big trouble with him because of our sins. But our sins can be forgiven, and that's why I'm here this afternoon, to tell you the good news of the Lord Jesus Christ, how he left heaven's glory to die upon the cross, be crucified that day and shed his precious blood, my friend, that you and I could be saved from a long-lost eternity. Yes, the Lord Jesus Christ loved us so much to die upon the cross. I now rejoice in my sufferings for you and fill up that which is behind of the afflictions of Christ in my flesh for his body's sake, which is the church, whereof I am made a minister according to the dispensation of God, which is given to me for you to fulfill the word of God, even the mystery which hath been hid from ages and from generations, but now is made manifest to his saints, to whom God would make known what is the riches of the glory of this mystery among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, or among you, the hope of glory, whom we preach, warning every man, and teaching every man in all wisdom, that we may present every man perfect in Christ Jesus. Whereunto I also labour, which worketh in me mightily. Yes, that man called Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, was mightily used of the Lord in the salvation of many souls. And I hope that I can be used in that way, that your soul be saved, my friend, because this is so important, it's so urgent, that we get right with God, that we have peace with God. Bible says in Romans 5:1, therefore being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm not interested in preaching anyone else, my friend. Only Christ and Him crucified. He's the one that died on the cross. He's the one that's worth preaching about. And there's only one really worth preaching about. That's the Lord Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, who was made sin for us, that we might be made the righteousness of God in Him. So that if you put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, your soul will be saved. This is exactly what God wants for you this afternoon, my friend. You know, if we go our own way, you see, there's a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. I wonder, are you heading in the wrong direction? Are you heading more and more away from God? You need to come to God through the Lord Jesus Christ, my friend. You need to put your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Do it now before it's forever and eternally too late. I wonder, what will you do then with Jesus, which is called the Christ? Will He be your Saviour or will He have to be your judge? It's either one or the other. You see, once you've heard the message of salvation for our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, you need to make a decision. You will. You'll either continue to reject or neglect the Lord Jesus as your Saviour, or you will receive Him. You can't sit on the fence. You are personally responsible before the God of heaven after hearing the gospel of Jesus Christ, how that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that He was buried, and that He rose again the third day according to the Scriptures. After hearing that message, my friend, you are responsible to do something with that message. You'll either receive Christ as your Saviour. I preached a message about that yesterday. What will happen if I receive Christ? And what will happen if I reject or neglect Christ? There's two outcomes for this. It's either heaven through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ by receiving Christ, or it's down in hell on the lake of fire for all of eternity because we have rejected or neglected the Lord Jesus Christ as our Saviour. And He will become our judge. Do you really think that God delights in judging people? It's His strange work. He doesn't want to have to judge you. But He will if you die without Christ. Outside of Christ, we're dead in our trespasses and in our sins, heading down to hell and the lake of fire for all eternity. But God wants you to be saved, my friend. That's why I'm here this afternoon, to preach the gospel, the good news, that Christ died for our sins according to the Scriptures, and that He was buried, and that He rose again the third day according to the Scriptures, and that your soul can be saved if you believe on Him, if you receive Him as your Saviour. Understand that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. There is not a just man upon the earth that doeth good and sinneth not. We're in the same boat, my friend. None of us can say that we've never ever sinned. That would be the first time we sinned. We'd be telling a lie. Look, God says, let God be true, but every man a liar. So we need to understand, if we want to know the truth, we have to come to the Word of God, the Bible. We'll have to be shut up to what God says, because God is the only one that knows what He's talking about. You and I don't know what we're talking about. That's why it says, let God be true, but every man a liar. Because we must put our confidence in God. And what God says goes, my friend. He is the one that is over all. And you and I need to understand that. He's the one that calls the shots, my friend. And if you and I reject what God has said concerning his son and the sacrifice of Jesus Christ upon the cross, we will bear the penalty of that for all of eternity. Why? Because we have rejected the only way of salvation found in our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ, who's crying out unto you this afternoon to come. He said, come unto me, all you that labour and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart, and you shall find rest unto your souls. I wonder, do you have rest, my friend, concerning your sin and in relation to eternity? We must understand that we're on a journey out into eternity. We're going to be somewhere at the moment of death. It's either heaven through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, or it's down in hell if we reject the Lord Jesus Christ. It's a terrible outcome, my friend. There's no need to go down to hell on the lake of fire. You can be in heaven. But it all depends what you do with the Lord Jesus Christ. Your eternal destiny, my friend, depends on your decision for or against the Lord Jesus Christ. He'll either be your Savior, or he'll have to be your judge. What will it be for you? Salvation or damnation? Heaven or hell? Peace with God, or remain as an enemy of God? It's up to you, my friend. You and I have an ever-existing soul that leaves our body at the moment of death. And as I said, we will be somewhere at the moment of death. Yes, they bury our body, that's sure. But our spirit and soul leave our body at the moment of death. Where will I be 5 seconds after I die? It all depends what you do with the Lord Jesus Christ, my friend. He is the answer to the big sin problem. You see, God has a problem with us, and it's called sin. You have freely that word that is so offensive to the God of heaven. And God must take care of sin. It's got to be judged. And if you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, the judgment for your sin has been passed upon Jesus Christ, and then you, my friend, can go free. Because his precious blood was shed, in whom we have redemption, through his blood even, the forgiveness of sins. Have your sins been forgiven? Are you on the way to heaven? Or still on the broad road that leads down to hell and destruction? If you're interested in this, look me up, youtube.com/peace by Jesus Christ. God bless you, and thanks for listening.